So some of the challenges that we face in Yarra at the moment over the years and into the future are that building cultural capital in an area, filling it with artists, will inevitably attract developers to capitalise on that.
That's why we've got this massive development of the inner suburbs, because of finally developers and real estate agents have realised you can transform these wonderful old 19th century buildings into something very useful now in the 21st century. But artists often are the first ones to initiate that movement.
There's a big demand for people to live in Yarra, and that means the supply of venues, residences can't meet the demand, and that major escalation in property prices, land values, which has seen quite a few venues converted from art studios or art precincts to residential or other land uses, which are seen as more lucrative.
You can't necessarily stop that process, but how you can go sideways and still encourage artists to be able to function within what is now very vital cultural areas, so that they continue to contribute to that vitality.
Once you've got a building or a space, that building or that space have lives of their own. It is crucial that there is money to sustain that practice in a space that evolves with the art form.
The Room to Create Fund is a community fund established by the City of Yarra with the Lord Mayor's Charitable Foundation to support the development of the arts in the City of Yarra and to engage the community in really supporting arts as a vehicle of social change and community engagement for the long term.
The Victorian music industry is really comprised of thousands of micro businesses who often run on the smell of an oily rag, and you know, quite a few operate out of their homes. You know, if they can stay in the City of Yarra, if rents or council-owned buildings, spaces, hubs can actually be sort of freed up, entice these businesses to come in and artists to be able to actually sort of work together and actually collaborate, I think it'd be fantastic.
So having people around you, a community full of artists and creative thinkers, enables you to have, you know, all sorts of interactions, and I guess facilitates collaboration between a lot of people, where you would not get that if you were working from your bedroom.
If there's a good sound link between economic development and arts and cultural scene, to attract the creative class, the young entrepreneurs, and there's a synergy between that.
We did a live music census last October, which found that there were 460 venues just in Melbourne, and it contributes $1.2 billion to the economy.
This year we've allocated $100,000 towards a Room to Create fund, and that $100,000 will be matched by the Lord Mayor's Charitable Foundation, and the aim is for that to be increased to $1 million. And the interest from that fund can then be applied to support arts and cultural communities and activities in the City of Yarra.
It's a fund where the community and the council have really thought, what is the issue that matters to our community, and focused their fund on that issue.
You can get one-off funds from state or federal government, but that's one-offs, and you need to be able to know that there will be somebody there to help you out when you need to make that improvement to the building.
We artists are lucky. We've got our own little rudder, which gives sense to our own lives as the rest of, you know, the rest of the society around has less and less sense. And if that produces work that reflects that in a way that it enriches the culture around us.
By giving to the Room to Create fund, you're actually helping build a legacy that will then fund the arts within the community of Yarra into the future. So it's not just a gift for now, it's actually a gift for the long term.